بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله والداعي إلى صراط مستقيم صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على نهجه واختفى أثره إلى يوم الدين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. After praising Allah Jalla Fi'ula and sending salutations upon our Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, we proceed. And alhamdulillah that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has gathered us here this evening. And we ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to make this a blessed gathering. And we ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to make us from those who have forgiven this gathering. Say ameen, you don't want dua? And we ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, just like He gathered us here this evening, that He gathers us in Jannah fi al-dawsi al-a'la. Innahu wa li dhalika al-qadr alayhi. Ayyuhal ikhwatu wal akhawat. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala in the Quran, He tells us about the purpose that He created us for. And He Jalla wa Ala, He tells us that the heavens and the earth and the whole universe has been created for one purpose. And that is that Allah Azza wa Jalla is glorified and worshipped alone. Where Allah Jalla wa Ala, He says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ I have not created jinkind and mankind except to worship me alone in worship. Jalla fi'ula. And whilst we have been created for that purpose, as human beings and sons of Adam alayhi salam, we make mistakes and we disobey Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala knowingly or unknowingly. We fall into sins and disobedience, and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has legislated for us a specific act of worship. That if we do it, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will rectify for us that which we have done wrong. Allah Azza wa Jal forgive us. And that is repentance. At-tawbah ila Allah Azza wa Jal. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah Azza wa Jal, he says something profound. That he says that the act of worship that the believer can never ever abandon, it is repentance. That he constantly repents to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And from the tricks of shaitan, it is that when you commit a sin, that he makes you feel so guilty, he makes you feel like you're not worth the forgiveness of Allah. He makes you delay repenting or not repenting at all. And Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah azza wa jalla, he says, not repenting from your sins, that's another sin that you are committing. So shaitan is making you commit another sin after the sin that you've done, which is not repenting to Allah azza wa jalla, because Allah commands us in the Quran to repent to Him. وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ And repent to Allah collectively, Allah says. O sinners, no, He says, O believers, a sign of iman, it is that you repent to Allah Azza wa Jal. فَأَمَّا مَن تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَعَسَى أَن يَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُفْلِحِينَ As for the one who repents and believes and does righteous deeds, he shall be among the successful. Your success lies in that. We find that those who preceded us, our previous predecessors, that we have certain narrations where they fell into grave sins, but they never despaired from the mercy of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and they immediately turned back to Allah Azza wa Jal. The Prophet ﷺ, after the incident of Al-Ahzab, where all the Arabs, the different parties amongst Arabs, they came together in order to completely annihilate the Prophet ﷺ, destroy him and the companions. They came together, they made an allegiance to fight against the Prophet ﷺ and his companions, and to surround them in Medina. The Jews of Medina, they had broken their contract to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, the agreement, and they joined the parties that were in opposition to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Amongst them was a tribe amongst the Jews known as Bani Qurayza. So after the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was successful after Ahzab, he decided that he's going to deal with these tribes that had betrayed him, and amongst them is Bani Qurayza. So the Prophet ﷺ sent a messenger to Bani Qurayza. Okay, because they were surrounded in their fortress. They could not get in or out. So he sent a messenger to them, and this messenger was a Sahabi, a companion known as Abu Lubaba, radiallahu anhu. Abu Lubaba, he had an agreement with Bani Qurayza previously, and he used to live in their lands. So the Prophet ﷺ sent Abu Lubaba because he was close to them to speak to them. But the intention of the Prophet ﷺ is to punish these people, right? But this is a secret, Bani Qurayza are not meant to know. Abu Lubaba goes to Bani Qurayza. They said, "Ya Abu Lubaba, what is Muhammad ﷺ going to do to us?" So Abu Lubaba, he can't tell them the secrets of the Prophet ﷺ. That is treason. But what did he do? He indicated with his finger, his hand, this, saying that you're going to be punished. And then as soon as he did that, he realized what he had done. That he had betrayed the Prophet ﷺ and exposed his secret. And that he committed a sin. What did he do? He rushed to the Prophet's messenger ﷺ. And he tied him up to one of the pillars. And when he tied himself to the pillar, he swore that he's not going to leave this position until Allah Azza wa Jalla accepts his repentance and the Prophet ﷺ unties him. So the Prophet ﷺ, he saw Abu Lubaba who was tied to this pillar. He asked, "What's the matter with Abu Lubaba? Why has he tied himself up?" Now bear in mind, the action that Abu Lubaba had done, nobody knows about it except himself. The Prophet ﷺ does not know about it because he wasn't there to witness it. But because of his God consciousness and the muraqabah of Allah Azza wa Jalla, knowing that Allah sees him, he held himself accountable and turned back to Allah immediately without delay. He hastened to seek the forgiveness of Allah Azza wa Jalla. And he remained like that for a whole week. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed an ayah in Surah At-Tawbah. وَآخَرُونَ اعْتَرَفُوا بِذُنُوبِهِمْ خلقوا عملا صالحا وآخر سيئا عسى الله أن يتوب عليهم إن الله غفور رحيم. That others, they admitted their sins, they acknowledged their sins, they mixed righteous deeds with evil deeds. Allah Azza wa Jalla will forgive them. Verily Allah is the all-forgiving and the most merciful. This ayah is revealed to the Prophet ﷺ when he was in the house of Salama radiallahu anha. And the Prophet ﷺ told Salama that the repentance of Abu Lubaba has been revealed. So then she said, "Ya Rasulullah, shall I give him glad tidings? He's in the masjid, tied up, just outside. Shall I go give him glad tidings?" He said, "If you wish, you could do so." So she said, "Ya Abu Lubaba, Allah Azza wa Jalla has accepted your repentance." And then the Sahaba who were there, they rushed to go untie him. He said, "No one can untie me until the Prophet ﷺ unties me." And then the Prophet ﷺ came and untied him. This is how they were. It's reported that there was another companion. He was paired up with the Prophet ﷺ with another companion. They were both Ansaris. And he made them brothers. One of these Ansaris, he traveled and he went on a journey. So he told his Ansari brother to look after his wealth and his property and his family whilst he's gone. So he agreed. So this Ansari brother would come to his house and check up on his family. One day, he saw his Ansari brother's wife. And then he felt attraction towards her. And then his desires overcame him and he approached to kiss her. She placed her hand on her mouth to prevent him. As soon as she did that, he realized what he had done. He ran to the mountains crying, seeking forgiveness from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And then he told the Prophet ﷺ what he had done. That he said, "I am doomed." And when his Ansari brother came back, he admitted to him what he had done, seeking his forgiveness. And he remained like that for days, crying over the sin that he committed. And then Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala revealed the ayah in Surah Al-Imran. والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون. Those who do obscenity, Allah says, and those who do obscenity, or they oppress themselves by committing sins, by disobeying Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. What do? They remember Allah Azza wa Jal. They remember their Creator, their Lord who sees them. And then فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا, immediately after that they seek forgiveness for their sins, because they know no one forgives their sins except Allah Azza wa Jal, and they're not persistent upon their sins whilst they know. This ayah, when it's revealed, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is indicating that Sahaba has been forgiven by Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. So the Prophet alayhi salatum told the companions to give glad tidings to this companion that Allah has forgiven his sin. And then Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, Ya Rasulullah, this verse, is it only special to this Sahabi, specific to him only? Or is it for everyone? And the Prophet alayhi salatum said, Bal hiya amma, it's for all the Muslims. Glad tidings to us all. This is how they were. They constantly engage. It doesn't mean that being righteous that you will not make sins, you will not commit sins, you will not make mistakes. It doesn't mean that. It means that you will. But what makes you better is that you turn back to Allah Azza wa Jal. Because repentance is the act of worship which makes Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala happy. Just like you have made Allah angry with you by sinning and disobeying him, make him happy by turning back to you and repenting to him. Because the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, Allah Jalla fi al-ulah is happier when you repent to him and turn back to him than the individual who was traveling in the desert and he had all his goods on his camel, and then he slept and he lost his camel, yeah, and all his goods, and he slept out of despair, and he woke up and he found his camel and all his goods there, and he out of joy, he said, Allahumma anta abdi wa ana rabbuk. He said, oh Allah, you're my slave and I'm your Lord. He made a mistake because of how happy he was. Allah is happier than that individual when you turn back to him. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah azza wa jalla, he mentions in Majmu' al-Fatawa that some of the Salaf rahimahullah azza wa jalla would say that Allah, now listen to this statement, it's a profound statement, that Allah azza wa jalla, he tests some of his righteous beloved slaves with certain sins so that they turn back to him because of how much Allah loves repentance. Allah tests some of his righteous beloved slaves with certain sins so that they turn back to him because of how much Allah loves repentance. Allahu Akbar, look at that. The Prophet ﷺ says, مَا مِنْ عَبْدٍ إِلَّا وَلَهُ ذَنْبٌ يُقِيمُ عَلَيْهِ حَتَّى يَلْقَ اللَّهِ. That there's no slave of Allah Azza wa Jalla except that there's at least one sin that he constantly falls into until he meets Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. That's our nature. But what makes us better is that repentance, that ibadah of at-tawbah ila Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. And that's what the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam taught the Sahaba. He told them to seek forgiveness from Allah and to turn back to him. And he said, I seek forgiveness from Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala 70 to 100 times a day. And he has no sins at all, alayhi salatu wasalam. Why is he doing that? To teach us that we need to constantly engage in that. It is our sins that prevent us from all khayr. It is our sins that prevent us from worshipping Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. They weigh us down. It is our sins that cause calamities and difficulties and hardships. Because Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala tells us precisely that in the Quran, that no calamity befalls you except because of what your own hands have done. وَيَعْفُوا عَنْ كَثِيرٌ. And Allah pardons a lot. If Allah was to hold us accountable for every sin that we have committed, we would not be able to live in this world. We'll face a calamity after calamity, but Allah overlooks a lot of our sins. But Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala tells us the purpose of these calamities and difficulties that we face. He Jalla wa Ala, he says, وَلَنُذِيقَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى دُونَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَكْبَرِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس ليذيقهم بعض الذي عملوا لعلهم يرجعون. وما نريهم من آية إلا هي أكبر من أختها وأخذناهم بالعذاب لعلهم يرجعون. All these verses Allah is telling us, وَلَنُذِيقَنَّهُمْ, that we certainly shall make them test. the smaller punishment, i.e. calamities and difficulties and hardships in this world, instead of the greater punishment, i.e. the punishment of the hellfire. Why? لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرَجُعُونَ So that they turn back to Allah and repent to Allah Azza wa Jal. When calamities occur and difficulties occur, the objective is that you return to Allah and seek forgiveness in Jalla fi'ula. Allah says, corruption has spread on the land and sea because of what mankind have done with their own hands to make them taste some of that which they have done so that they turn back to Allah Azza wa Jal. Repentance. Allah says, we do not show them a sign except that it's the following sign that comes after is greater than it. And we punish them in this world. We trial them in this world. We put them through difficulties in this world so that they turn back to Allah Azza wa Jal. That is the objective. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah Azza wa Jal, he says that every blessing that distances you from Allah Azza wa Jal in reality is a calamity. And every calamity that draws you closer to Allah Azza wa Jal, that is really a blessing. That is the way you're meant to view it. Everything that makes you closer to Allah, it's a blessing. Everything that furthers you away from Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is a calamity. So that's why the ulama, they say that sometimes the most difficult tests are blessings. Because when we are constantly blessed, sometimes we forget Allah. We become distant from Allah. We forget our obligations towards Allah. We become heedless. But when we tested with hardship, we automatically remember Allah. We turn back to Allah. We call upon Allah. We seek aid from Allah. And Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala does not disappoint a slave who turns to Him. Allah Azza wa Jalla never abandons a slave who turns to Him. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala always aids a slave who seeks His assistance sincerely, believing in Him and worshipping Him. That is Allah Azza wa Jal. That is the Lord that we are worshipping. He forgives every sin. There's no sin that's too great for Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive. Even shirk, one who associates upon us with Allah Azza wa Jal, if he repents before he dies, Allah will forgive him. So it's a matter of just taking a step towards Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala without delay. Because Allah Azza wa Jal instructs us that in the Quran, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ
Hasten, rush towards the forgiveness of your Lord. Don't delay it. And Jannah, its width is the size of the heavens and the earth. It has been prepared for the God conscious, those who fear Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. The poet, he would say that we need to be conscious of Allah Azza wa Jal and know the greatness of the one that we are disobeying. It is not about how small the sin is or how insignificant it is in your sight. It's about the greatness of the one that you're disobeying. And that Allah Azza wa Jal sees you doing it. It's a matter of having that shyness of Allah Azza wa Jal. إِذَا خَلَوْتَ بِرِيبَةٍ فِي ظُلْمَةٍ وَالنَّفْسُ دَاعِيَةٌ إِلَى الطُّغْيَانِ فَاسْتَحِي مِنْ نَظَرِ الْإِلَهِ وَقُلْ لَهَا إِنَّ الَّذِي خَلَقَ الظَّلَامَ يَرَانِي
He says, if you're alone by yourself in the darkness, no one can see you by yourself, and your soul is calling you towards evil to disobey Allah Azza wa Jal. Be shy of the sight of Allah Azza wa Jal, that Allah sees you, and say to your soul, verily the one who created the darkness can see you. That is what protects an individual from falling into that. Not being careful. And that is what taqwa is. Like the poet would say, خَلِّ الذُّنُوبَ كَبِيرَهَا وَصَغِيرَهَا ذَاكَ التُّقَى وَاصْنَعْ كَمَاشٍ فَوْقَ أَرْضِ الشَّوْكِ يَحْذَرُ مَا يَرَى وَلَا تَحْقِرَنَّ صَغِيرَةً إِنَّ الْجِبَالَ مِنَ الْحَصَى He said, leave the sins, abandon the minor and major. That is taqwa, God consciousness. And be like one who is walking on a land that's filled with thorns. He's careful of where he treads. And do not belittle any sin. Because mountains, they are made of pebbles, they accumulate. And that's what the Prophet ﷺ, he said, Be aware of the small sins that people, they belittle, because they destroy the one who does it. So we ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to forgive our sins. And we ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to have mercy upon us. And we ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to accept our repentance. We ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to forgive all our sins. And we ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to make us from those who hear this speech and follow the best of it. And we ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to soften our hearts. And we ask Allah Jalla fi'ula to rectify our hearts. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us from those who worship Him as He deserves to be worshipped. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to aid us and assist us in His worship. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to have mercy upon us. And we ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to forgive us and our parents, and to have mercy upon us and them. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla, just like He united us here this evening, that He unites us in Jannah al-Firdaws al-A'la. إنه ولي ذلك القادر عليه وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين والحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خيرا.